Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So you have a table called employees with the columns employee ID and salary, and you have 9 employees and the salaries, and the output is you need to add a column called bucket, and you need to categorize or divide the employees into buckets based on the salaries in ascending order. So for the first three salaries, the least salaries, they are in bucket 1, and the next two salaries in bucket 2, and next two in bucket 3, and next two in bucket 4. So the bucket 4 salaries are the salaries with having the highest salaries. So this is the question. So now let's see how to solve this using SQL. So I already have the DMN script ready for employees and the salaries. So select star from employees. So this will give me the input, select star from employees. So now there is a inbuilt function in SQL called entile. So entile automatically buckets the employees, buckets these numbers into categories. Suppose, so now what I'll do, I'll create a new column, select star comma entile of 4 over order by salary as bucket from employees. So this will automatically give me the buckets based on the salaries input. So this is the question which the employee has already answered, but the interesting part is you need to solve this without using entile function. So with entile function, if you know what is entile function, you can easily do this, but the main challenge over here is without using entile function. So first what I'll do, I'll write a select statement, select from employees. So first I'll keep the star, and what I'll do, I'll create a row number, distinct row number over order by salary as rn. So when I create the row number I will get the row numbers for each of the salary in ascending order. So for the least salary, it is row number 1, and the highest salary, it is the row number 9. So I'll create one more column called count of over of as cnt. So count of 1. So I'm calculating the total row count. So count of 1 with over clause gives me the total count, total row count of this table, and that particular row count is added as a new column for each of the row in this table. Since we have 9 rows, the value 9 is added as in a new column for this table for each of the row. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as, and select from CTE, so employee ID comma salary comma RN into, since we want 4 buckets, right? So in 1 2 3 4, what I'll do, RN into 4.0 divided by CNT as bucket. So when I do this, what am I getting? This is what I'm getting, 00111, like this. But so if we compare it, this is the output we require. So for the first 3 rows, it should be 1. So for this first 3 rows, it should be 1. And for the next 2 rows, it should be 2, 3 and 4. So here if you see, for 4, that means these 2 rows are 4. That means you can automatically round this integers to its nearest number, right? So when I round these integers to the nearest number, what am I getting? Round of round comma 0. Okay, so when I'm trying to round it, not here, it is here. So, well, I'll try to round this. Round comma 0. So, when I try to round this, this is what I get: 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 4, 4. Everything is fine, but the first value is 0. So, what I'll do, suppose I'll write a case statement, case round of 0, when 0, then 1, else this entire value. And as bucket. So now let's see what we are getting. Okay, I have missed the end value here. End. So now if I run, this is what I get. So 1 1 1 2 2 3 3 and 4 4. So now this is matching with the entile function. Entile function's output is matching, but I need to remove the decimals here. So what I'll do here, I'll write cast off. So this entire value, I'll convert this into decimal of 5, 0. So when I convert it to decimal of 5, 0, I have kept the decimal points as 0. So that means it will not give me any decimal parts. So now this is how now this output is matching with the entire function's output. So this is how you convert you bucket the data without using entire function.